So remember, the discrete Fourier transform gets samples, frequency samples in there. I should write this like capital X, X of k. So these are frequency samples. So then this is here our inverse discrete Fourier transform. And then this sends out a sequence in sampled time. So this is here sampled. Length n, and in our case here, this is equivalent to the length of the symbol. So that's pretty important here that we remember this here. So the IDFT has certain lengths. So the mass behind this is now the following. So we've got our x of n. And then this is 1 over n. Remember, this is length of our DFT or our symbol here in this case. So this runs from 0 to n minus 1. X of k, these are our frequency samples. Then this is multiplied by a complex frequency here. So that's our discrete inverse Fourier transform here. Should write this here with an I. Discrete inverse Fourier transform here. And so these are here our complex, this is our complex time series. And these are here our complex frequencies. Complex frequencies. And so we've got this time, complex time series is n samples. And also here we have n samples. You see the n shows up here again.